Wednesday, December 13th. Beautiful day outside, if you guys see. That's a great day to win. So I mean, I'm super excited today to be able to help you guys, sharing with you guys some good information that I feel like helped me out a lot. I was thinking, I was like, okay, what can I give the team? I want to give you guys, be able to give you guys some new information, something that I feel like is needed, especially right now for all of you newly licensed districts, new field trainers, people who are wanting to go out there and start developing teams, people who are wanting to become a broker here. What is it that you guys are missing? What is it that is needed, right, to be a fantastic field trainer, right? That's the first thing that I'll be covering. And, you know, before I get started, I see a lot of sharp people here on the Zoom call. I see a lot of sharp people here present in the office. And I just want to say, guys, that this is what it's going to take, okay? It's going to take you guys showing up here early, consistently, whether you guys want to or not, whether you guys are having a bad morning or a great morning. It's the consistency of doing it day in and day out, right? So I commend you guys for being here, because it's silly that, you know, the top earners in this whole entire office and our whole entire organization are here present, right? And how many of us want to be able to make the incomes of $20,000, $30,000, $40,000, $50,000, $70,000, $80,000 a month? Well, I think it's super silly, right? The people that say they want to do those things, but unfortunately their actions aren't congruent to what they're doing, right? They're not showing up early like we are, right? They're not consistently getting better. They're not making sure they, you know, are being the example that they want their team to be, okay? So today, my goal is just to be able to deliver for you guys some great information. I have this amazing PowerPoint, right? Hopefully you guys like that. I worked super, super hard on it, okay? So maybe if I can just help one of you guys get something today, right? If something just clicks for you guys today, right? I feel like I did a good job, okay? So I'm going to be doing covering the first half of training, and I'm going to pass it over to Alejandro, and he's going to deliver his half, okay? But for those of you who don't know who, you know, I am, my name is Luis Camejo. I've been here now coming up on January 4 years, which is crazy. I signed my IBA on December 19th of 2019. Right, with Edward and my brother Alejandro as well, which is super, super fantastic. And little did I know that today, you know, we'd be having the lifestyle that we have today. I wanted it to happen, right? You know, I knew I was going to be, you know, ever since young, no one can ever tell me that I wasn't going to be successful. No one could ever tell me that I wasn't going to have a strong, big business, because I knew that was the type of person that I was, that I had it in me. I knew I was going to, you know, stake my face for our family and make sure that I did something amazing. But little did I know that it was going to be Primerica that was going to deliver that for me. You know, little did I know, right, that 3.5 years later, right, you know, I have such an amazing team, right, amazing people being able to help out, you know, over 1,000 clients now, you know, with their life insurance, which is huge. And it all started with the decision that, you know, we decided to make 3.5 years ago, you know what, to be fully committed to doing something like this. We burnt all of our bridges before this. We were both student athletes, and, you know, I actually also had prior business ventures that I was getting into that I knew for sure I was going to do amazing at. But, you know, when better opportunity comes along, right, you got to be mature enough to understand it and jump on it, right, and capitalize it, right? So I saw a great example. It was free mentorship, and I know somebody was killing it, so I jumped on board, right? And now, you know, we have this amazing team. We have this amazing organization, and I'm blessed to be able to teach you guys and show you guys exactly kind of how we did it. And, you know, we can also teach you guys some of the things that stopped us from doing it quicker, you know, so that you guys can do it quicker. I love to do that as well, okay? But with that being said, let me just share my screen. I'm going to give you guys a little quick presentation, cover the first couple half of training, then I'll pass it on to Alejandro to give you guys some good substance towards the end, okay? You guys excited?
Yes, sir.
Awesome. So it's never too late, guys. Make sure you keep messaging your teammates, right? And doing better, right? So when I was in college, guys, what's crazy is I never actually had an iPad or a Mac, right? When I was in college, I did everything through my phone, right? So I actually got really good at using this thing, right? I got really, really good at it. I actually did all my presentations through college, which was about once a week, right? If you guys went to a college, I did them all on my phone. I used to do them all on my phone, right? So I mastered getting really, really good at doing presentations on my phone. They were never the best, right? But guess what? You know, they're good enough to get the information across. All right. So today what I'll be covering is how to properly field train somebody, right? How is it that you should be able to field train? How is it that Alejandro and I are constantly being able to get somebody brand new right? That doesn't know nothing and be able to turn them into a full-time stud, right? Like the examples that we have here in our office, right? How is that we've been able to do it? And I feel like I put together a couple of key elements that helped us along the way, right? And it wasn't always great from the beginning. We were amazing field trainers from the beginning, but from the help of our coaches and guidance and getting better, you know, we were able to develop into strong field trainers that we are today. Okay. And the first step, you know, that I feel like is super important when becoming a strong field trainer is you got to give people tasks from the beginning. Okay. You know, when someone comes on board, they get signed their IBA. The first thing that has to get done is people have to already be invested. People are giving themselves their 2024. They already invested into doing something like this. You got to give people tasks. Show people that it's real, right? You know, if we do a Zoom presentations, have them go and do their fingerprints, right? A lot of us here got our fingerprints, you know, our first 1 to 2 weeks before we were even licensed, we were already fingerprinted, right? So it's crazy when we are coming in, right? We're having people, you know, we want them to set KTs, we want them to close 4,000 before we even send to fingerprints. No, do the work before, right? Get people doing activity, and I promise you will be able to get more because people are more invested into it, right? Second thing, get people set up for their fingerprints. Make sure you also set people up for their classes, right? When people are seeing that they're getting better, when they have tasks in front of them, they will always, right, be more invested. There'll be more when they've done 10 hours in a class. Don't you think people are gonna want to get their license? Right? The majority of them will, right? Obviously, there's the people that don't go through with it, right? Just like there's people that go to college for 3, 4 years and then decide to drop out right before they're like at the finish line and decide to leave, right? Why is it? Why is it that people will play a sport all the way up from when they're 5 years old, all the way up to when they're 18, about to graduate high school, and then their senior year, like, you know what? I don't want to play anymore. You've already invested all this time. You've already done so much. You might as well just finish out, right? And this is what it's all about. But you want to make sure that people are constantly being invested right from the beginning, right? That is step number one to being a strong field trainer, making sure people are getting tasked and invested from the beginning. Okay. Now, step number two, and it's super important, and this is where the orientation, right? That first 5 hours that you have with them. Once you first meet somebody, for example, let's say I just met Damien, he's a new trainee. Those first 5 hours, all I'm doing, right, those first few appointments that I'm doing with him, I'm just making sure that I set an expectation for him, right? That he understands, he has a clear view of exactly what is the task at hand. What is it? Setting up appointments, making sure that they get district leader, understanding the importance of a big bonus, having them understand why recruiting is so important. Right? You want to set an expectation early on. How soon? How fast? How much should they be showing up? Right? You know, what it is that we need from them? Set that expectation right away. Right? And that also goes with setting KTs at the orientation. Okay? And Edward's been talking about this a lot recently. And I see this happening a lot. People are like, man, I don't think people scheduling KTs from at the orientation. Guys, because we're not setting the expectation right away. From the moment that we have jump on that interview, we have to start setting the expectation. Hey, what are we gonna do? Look, you know, when I got started, this is how we did it, right? I want to go see this person, my aunt. Now that's how I got my training done, right? Right now, Jonathan, quick question. Let's say you were opening up a restaurant, okay? Who are you inviting to your grand opening?
Friends and family,
Why?
because I'm closest with them and they support me.
Of course, right? You know, so doesn't it make sense, right? If you go into business with yourself, right, you should probably introduce or show something like this to the people that you know first. Right? For all the ladies in the room, right? How many of us probably have known somebody that's getting into doing nails, hair, right? You know, and who are the first people that they always practice on?
Friends and family.
Why is it? Why is it that we always cater to doing it that way? Right? But then we come into Primerica and we're like, oh no, but I don't want to talk to anyone that I know. I want to talk to people that I know. You know, it's silly, right? Every business works the same exact way, right? Amazon first started selling books. Right, you know, to local people in this in his own neighborhood, and then it started growing and growing and growing, right? But everything starts off small. Whenever we have a restaurant, right, most people are amazing cooks before they start opening up a restaurant, right? And how do they get their name out there of having such amazing food? Well, look, you know, they start doing catering here for this person. They start catering over there. Now they start selling their services, right? And now they get to the size of like, you know what? I think I can open up a restaurant. Right? And every single time, right, this happened to me literally yesterday. There's this new restaurant that I saw someone post on Instagram. The restaurant was amazing. They sold some Italian deli sandwiches. I went to go try it out. It was near downtown. And it was amazing. Ari, it was like the best Italian, like new authentic New York sandwich I had ever had. Like it literally reminded me of when I was back in college. That's how good the sandwich was. Right. And I didn't pay for any advertising. That guy didn't pay me, right, to show up. Right. But I knew this person. I knew he was credible, right? His social, I knew he was a credible person when it comes to good food choices, right? Because I ate at one of the places that he's shown before, right? And I went to go try it out. And guess what? It was just as amazing. It was just as amazing as it said, right? And that's how word of mouth gets spread out. Right, but what do you have to do to be a good field trainer? You have to give people these examples. You got to give people a clear picture, right? So they, when they come in, they know exactly what's going to happen. And what you do is you base it, you give them examples, real life examples of something that they've probably done in the past, right? Good field trainers are always really good at giving a Primerica information and then relating it to something outside of Primerica. Like that is so easy. And Jake, it's like so clear that people know exactly what they're doing. Right, that's always done, and set the expectation for a big bonus, 3x3, 5x5, 10x10, and then put the workload behind it.
Can you use an example of buying some?
Just gave you like three of them, bro.
Another one.
Another one?
Yeah.
Oh, so give me an example of something. Like what? Like when it comes to an orientation, give me an example of something that you feel like you want to get a good life
Doing
with.
the 3x3.
The 3x3. Awesome. Awesome. Yeah. So it goes back. So when you're doing your 3x3, all you're doing is you're putting yourself in front of people and people are getting the result, right? It's exact same thing. Like when I said about the people that do nails, it's the same way, right? You know, first of all, right, you know, let's say Nelson that you start doing nails, right? You know, but you know, you're not too good. You can't charge people to do nails, right? So who are you gonna ask to do their nails for? You're gonna ask Ari, hey Ari, look, you know, I just bought this set. I'm gonna start doing nails. Girl, can I practice on you? Yeah, you know what? And then it's like, and then Ari goes to school, right? Well, Ari goes to school, right? Whatever it is. And then her nails are all nice. And then Ari's homegirl's like, girl, look at your nails. And she's like, you know what? You gotta go to my bestie for for the restie, Nelson. Right? And then Nelson, right, gets a free referral, right? And he starts charging. Right now it's not free. Right now he's like, you know what? Yeah, so it's actually gonna be like $30, right? Well, guess what? That was a free referral, and you actually got compensated from that as well. Right? So all it was is people saw that there was a need, right? And then next time, right, guess what? You might even charge Ari as well. Right? Because Ari was like, hey, these nails actually came out pretty good. I needed it. Right? I actually need it. Let me actually go ahead and do it. Right? So it's the same thing when you're doing a KT. Right, because people will come on board to help you out, right? But then they realize that they actually need it, right? They're like, damn, I need the life insurance. I need to get it, right? You know what? Let me go ahead. You know what? You're right. Let me do it, right? And it's the same way for the 3x3 as well, for the three recruits. How many times don't we sit down with people that hate what they do, need to make more money? They're constantly complaining about money, right? That's all Alejandro and I did at the beginning. We're like, bro, look, we're doing this. I know you're always talking about how about, you know, how broke you are, how you need more money. Well, look, this might actually be something good for you. We're gonna give it a shot, you know, at least you can maybe join with us. That's it. It's that simple, right? You'd be surprised at the amount of people that will actually do it if you talk to them that way. Okay, you just want to set a big example after doing it big. And then step number three to being a great field trainer is you got to sell people on the crusade, right? It mind boggles me the amount of people that will come on board. Right, and they'll do this orientation so logically, right? When this 18-year-old person doesn't understand what life insurance is, but yet you want them to schedule 6 to 7 appointments. Most people, the reason why they don't schedule a lot of appointments, especially younger people, is because they are scared of what you're gonna tell to their parents. They are scared of what you're gonna show them, right? They don't know. They don't be like, man, what if this guy just goes on and like says some crazy stuff on here, like. So what would I do, right? If I have a new person on that orientation, I ask them, hey, let me ask you a question. Do you know what life insurance is? Do you know what the importance of it is? Oh no, I don't. Well, man, look, think about it. How many people, right, during COVID, and you see we're passing away? How many GoFundMes did you see? Right? Let me ask you a question, right? We all hate to ask and beg for money, don't we? Right? So if someone had $100,000 of life insurance, do you think they would need to do something like that? No. You think they'd want to do something like that if they had the money available to pay for that funeral? No. So the life insurance is important, right? Imagine, man, look, even if we don't do something like this crazy, even Jonathan, if you come in and let's say you don't kill it here, you don't do this full time, but you're able to help out a couple families. Let's say that, God forbid, down the road, you know what? Unfortunately, that one of those clients that you helped out from a referral, let's say unfortunately they need that life insurance and they got helped out with us. Right? How would you feel that you were able to do something like that for them? That's really good, right? You know, so what we do here is good, guys. It's really great. And also how people explain the Rule 72, right? Another example as to how I tell people about the Rule 72 and the importance of sitting down with people to educate them on this, right? Another example, Nelson, look, what's the average age of the people that you see working at like the cash register, like Walmart and like in Publix? Super, probably old, right? And some of them are like super old, right? Now, do you think that those people want to be there? Realistically, do you think the majority of them want? They probably don't, but they guess what? They have to. Why? Because when they were early on, no one sat down with them and explained to them the importance of saving money. No one talked to them and sat down on the importance of a Roth IRA, saving for your retirement, right? Imagine, Nelson, if you could help somebody, right, be able to save an extra a couple hundred thousand for their retirement, right? So like that, they don't have to be working there, right? You know, they can choose to, but they don't have to, right? Wouldn't that be something good?
Yes.
Right. So look, do you see why it's so important that we go and educate people on these subjects? Right. Don't you see why it's so important? This is why I fell in love with the company. Right. I'll give my own experience. Right. My dad, he owned a landscaping company. Super hardworking. Right. My dad only spoke Spanish, but he busted his back. And when he was working in his business, he was making decent money. Right. But he saw my mom had a job and she had a what? A 401k. My mom was saving for her retirement. My dad, he was like, shit, I need to save for my retirement. I would be busting my back, cutting grass for the rest of my life. So what did my dad would go? He would go to the bank, right? And he would ask, hey, do you guys offer 401ks? Right? Now, what do you think the bank people told him? Mind you, most of the people that work at banks, they mostly only speak English. And very few of them actually have the knowledge to educate people on something like this. Right? And what do they tell them? Oh, you can't get a 401k. It's only for employees. How the fuck am I supposed to save for my retirement? Right, but little did no one have, right, the audacity to tell my dad, no, you don't need a 401k, you need a Roth IRA, that's what you need. You need to go find this, right? But not only because there was a language barrier, but they probably didn't make any money, they probably weren't incentivized to talk good on that behalf or to give that information. So now, 4 years later, when Edward sat down with my parents, now my dad opened up his Roth IRA. Right, because now he knows better. And when people know better, they do better. Right? This is why it's so important, like, to educate people on what we do. Give them these examples. I'm telling you, it's gonna make your life so much easier. And the next thing that you need to be a great field trainer is you need to have excitement. Right? But you can't also have crazy excitement. It needs to be good. It needs to be a sharp excitement, something that's encouraging, not a crazy excitement, right? Because there's crackhead excitement too. You don't want to be like a crackhead either, right? We all know those people. Like when we go to down, I live in downtown, right? I see this all the time. People at 7 in the morning, all fired up, pumped up. That's not the excitement that you want. It needs to be controlled. It needs to be good. It needs to be genuine. Hey, Johnny, man, you're gonna be such an awesome. If you just keep doing what you're doing, and we keep going on this, man, I know you're gonna be doing something incredible here. Right? That is the excitement that you need to give people. You need to give them confidence. Right, you know, an appointment blows out. You're already on the Zoom. Hey, man, look, let's go real quick. Let me help you out. Let's knock out a chapter real quick. Jonathan, I know for sure, man. Look, I'm investing time with you, brother, because I know you're gonna do something special here. If we just keep doing what we've already been doing, you're gonna be another great example of our agency. You see, that is good excitement, good knowledge that you're pouring into people, right? You know, encourage them to do more, right? And also, you need to make sure, guys, that we reach out to our teams daily. Right, so many times you want to get more out of our people, more out of our people, right? But it's not genuine. People can notice a person looking for a sale from a mile away, right? Sometimes I hear us and we're calling our team and we're like, "Do you have any appointments for today?" "No." "Okay, can you schedule some appointments?" "Come on, man, like we need to do this right through or what?" No, call and be like, yo, what's up, man? Like, how's your day going? Dude, how's work? You know, how's everything? Look, man, how's the licensing going? Man, look, remember, I'm here to help you out. Look, if you have anything, please let me know. Right? Doesn't that sound so much more diff so different? Right? So sometimes people need to hear that. Like, it needs to be genuine. It just can't be you're looking for transactions after transaction. You just call them for a transaction. And you can like, oh my God, here comes for he's calling me again to see who the we'll get for a KTF, but I'm not even gonna pick up. And that's why you probably don't have a lot of your teammates, right, picking up your phone calls. You know, it's because they are not excited to talk to you, right? They know when you're gonna talk to them is to either say something bad, right, or to get something more out of them. We have to make sure we keep changing that, okay? Now, and step number five, and this is so important when you as being a good field trainer. It's not only about the production. It's not only about what happens in this beautiful little office that we have when we go when we turn on our Zoom. It's also what happens outside, right? Are we building relationships, right? I am honored to say that every single person that comes through our team, right? You know, we have a relationship with every single one of them, right? We introduce ourselves. We go out of our way to make sure we can connect with every single person on our team. Right, because I want to make sure that when something happens, they feel comfortable enough to come with us, to come to us and give us and let us give them guidance on how to overcome something. Right, I want to make sure that I don't want just to have people that show up to the office and say, oh my God, Ali and Lewis, they're just doing this to get more transactions out of people. Like, no, we want to build genuine relationships. That's why if when it comes to every single person on our teams, we always invest time with them in some different way. Right, you know, the cool thing about Alejandro and I is that. You know, we both like to do anything and everything, you know, so we'll hang out with everybody, no matter doing what it is, and we'll have a blast doing it, right? But you gotta make sure that you're always building genuine relationships with your people, right? Spend time with them, right? You know, this is a good example. This is what, we, you know, at our old apartment, we'd always have, you know, our team over, and we were constantly doing the same thing, right? Now, as we've gotten bigger, right, you know, we have to be a little more selective, right, with who we invite over because it's way too many people, but the good thing is that we're still building relationships. We're still spending time with our people. You know, we want to make sure that we have them on our side. We want to be together. We want to be able for them to come to us, right, and ask for help. Now, this and the sixth thing when it comes, right, to being a great field trainer is you always have to be coaching. Always be coaching. All right. If people are saying, you know what? Oh my God, Lewis, you're always saying something. It's always another training. It's always another meeting. Well, guess what? Still coach. Because if they signed their one something their IBA with us, right? They signed up, right, to get taught the business. They signed up. And if they were if they knew all the information that I was coaching them on, right, they'd already be making my money, the type of money that we make. Right. So if you're not making the kind of money that we make, obviously you need to hear more coaching. You know, and we are always going to encourage our team to always deliver. This was us brand new. This was at our old office. That's me all the way back here in the corner. And as you guys can see, we always had a team of people around us. We were division leaders here, guys. We were brand new. But what was I doing? No matter what. Okay, hey man, look, we got some time right now. We don't have any appointments. Coach, teach them, spend time with them. If they're not in person, now we have Zoom. This was pre-Zoom era. Well, guess what? That's always, let's do Zooms. I don't got shit going on. I'm already here at the office. I'm gonna invest some time with them, right? You know, look, that's it's so funny, man. And every single one of those people have quit. But I am grateful for every single one of those people because if it wasn't for them, I probably wouldn't be here today, right? I thank every single person that has came into that silent IBA with us because it's either helped us in one way or another, right? You know, either showed us what to do with people and what not to do with people as well. Right, so you got to be grateful for every single no, every single appointment that says no, every single appointment that cancels, every policy that declines. I appreciate every single one of them, right? Because if it wasn't for those, probably wouldn't I wouldn't be the person that I am today. I know that for sure. Okay, you know, and always make sure, guys, that you're providing new information for your team. Right, this is so crucial. You got to be able to analyze your business and see what you need. Right, you know, like we're looking at the numbers yesterday. And we have now 31 recruits, and we're at 11,600 in premium. So we're like, okay, you know, what is the focus, right? We have a good decent amount of recruits. We can always have more, but you know, we got to make sure that there's people understanding the how to get on appointments, how to field train, right? So what's the training on today? how to field train, right? And Alejandro's gonna do a presentation on how to do a great orientation finishing out, because I feel like that's what the team needs. But I'm gonna deliver the same old information in a new way, right? Because sometimes you just need to hear it in a different way, right? In a different tone, with some different pictures, right? You know, in a dip with different examples, and like that'll resonate a little bit better. Okay. And the last one is, as I said, right, you know, make sure that you're always teaching your people and not just looking for transactions, and make sure that people are joining into the boot camps, joining into the training, joining into the PDRs, right? We have strategically done trainings and host trainings in the mornings and the evening times. We don't do that for our health. We do it strategically so people don't have an excuse to say, oh my God, Lewis, I hate Primerica because I feel like I didn't learn anything. I know if you give us 15 and 30 days and you commit to our schedule, you'll by the end of those 30 days know how to do a presentation, know how to talk to people, at least understand your dress code, right? Understand what it's gonna take, what it's not gonna take as well. Okay? Now, the next step is, in step number seven, you gotta understand the power of duplication when it comes to field training. The point of us field training people, guys, it's not to get 3x3. It's not for them to get to for us to do 10,000 personal. That is a byproduct of us field training. Right? But that's not the reason. The reason why Alejandro and I field train is to develop people, to have more players, right? We do not do nothing if we have someone do 10,000, right? And they're field training, and that person still doesn't know how to do a presentation, right? They're not licensed, they don't get the business. Right, because all we did was close a couple of policies, right, that might even fall off the books, right, by the end of the day. But I know if we develop people, right, and Jay comes in, we do his 5x5, he kills it, he makes money in his training, he learns a presentation, right, he understands and sees an example. Now, what's he gonna do? He's gonna wanna do something like this as well. He's gonna come full time, right? That's another player, right? The whole goal of us field training is to develop people, get transactions, but also make sure that people are getting put in place, right? Like that, we don't have to do this forever, right? I'm telling you guys, if you guys continue to do look for premium, you guys are gonna be sick and tired after 5 years, because you look for all this premium and you have nobody on your team. You're gonna have to keep doing it over and over again, right? And it's gonna start getting boring. It's gonna start getting tiring, right? But if you do it this way, you'll do good, right? So when it comes to duplication, what do you want to make sure people do? They become independent producing agents. They understand the phone calls, right? By this time, people have understood the presentation and people have gotten a good bonus, right? Key example of prime duplication. Look at this awesome couple right here, right? This is a prime example of duplication. They came in, we field trained them, they got a big bonus. They started becoming independent producing agents, right? They got their licenses and now they're amazing field trainers. You see, but what if Alejandro and I were just saying, you know what, bro? Hey, you have more KTs? Oh yeah, I think I have two more. All right, and then start closing on the phone. I never teach them the presentation. I never encourage them to come full time, right? We never encourage them to get better, right? To self-develop, right? You know, to show up. We stop coaching. You think they'd probably still be here today? No. Right, so it's a combination of doing all the right things. That is what field training is all about, right? And the last step that I want to share with you guys on being a successful field trainer is you gotta have people come full time. Okay, you gotta this is be has to be a constant conversation with your people. Okay, people quit everything. All right, you can't make sure, right? You can't always ensure that people are gonna do this full time, but I am gonna drill into their heads that the only way that people are gonna maximize the opportunity is full time. Have you guys ever seen a part-time millionaire in Primerica yet?
No.
No, it's not gonna happen. I don't know not one single millionaire that's not a regional vice president that's fully committed, that's invested, that sacrificed things, that became big, that showed up early. Right, so I see so many people that want to be making all this crazy amount of money, but they're doing all the wrong things, right? You know, but yet they talk like, oh my God, Alan Lewis, like, man, I'm gonna make just as much money as you guys are as your age. No, you're wrong, because that we were 19, 20 years old, we were showing up early, we were consistently showing up, we double digited every single month. We always had layers of players, we always had teams, we always had pockets of people, right? We were always building relationships. You see, so if you want to get the same results that we have, you got to have done what we did, right? If not, even more. Okay? So Next thing is you got to be a leader. You got to be someone that people want to follow, right? Leadership is so important. It's not just, the way you look, it's not just the way you talk, but it's also the way that you act. How do you carry yourself, right? How are you around other people? Are you making the money, right? And that's so important. You got to be a full-round leader, but it all starts with you, right? Before this, I was a full-time athlete. Not gonna lie, I was pretty decent. I wasn't bad. I was a pretty good athlete. But why was this? Because I always wanted to be the number one person on the team. I had joined three new teams in my whole entire career in soccer, and every single time I joined a new team, my mission was in the first month for people to see that I was the top player of that team. I'm gonna do everything it takes to be the top player of that team, right? And that way, I knew for sure that I was always gonna get playing time, right? In my college, I was the youngest person in my whole entire conference. I was 17, right? And in my college, in my own team, there's a guy who's 26 years old. I literally called him grandfather, right? Everyone called him grandfather. There's like, imagine there's 9 years of difference in age. But guess what? My first year as a freshman, I started the most games, right? I just took one opportunity for someone, right, that was in my position, he was a sophomore at the time, to get injured for me to come in, and he never played ever again. Right? Because I made it a mission that when I got on that field, pray, right? Because it was not, you're never gonna touch that field again, at least on my position. Right? Because I made it clear that this was something that I was gonna do, and I was gonna be the top player. Right? So if you guys have decided to be here to come to do something like this full time, be the top player. Don't just mope around. Right, be here to be excellent, be great, right? Anything in life, the only people that make it big are the top, right? Everyone's talking right now about Shohei Ohtani's top, his contract. Well, why do you think he's getting that contract? It's because he's the top of the top. They're not giving that contract to a triple-A player, right? But a triple-A player will beat every single college player, right? But he's not making the money because you have to be the top of the top to make it. Right? And every single level, guys, it just gets more and more and more hard, right? But as it goes up, the more and more money gets made, right? Everyone's talking right now about Willie, also crossing the $5 million in our company. Great accolade, right? I love it. But I know for sure, right, that he did, before he was making all that money, he was the top person of his organization. He was the top regional. He was at the top. He was the top RVP, right? He got his ring as a regional. Right? He was the top of the top in every single category. Right? So if you guys want to be a big RVP, you guys want to be the next $5 million earners, you got to be the top of the top in every single category. That's why I know for sure, Alejandro and I'm not worried about if we're going to get to the million. I know it's just a matter of time. I know we're going to get the two, the three, the four, the five as well. Why? It's because we are on a mission to be the top of the top in every single category. We're not looking at SVP. Right? We know it's gonna happen. We're gonna, okay, how big can we get this shit when we are RVPs? How big can we get it? Right? Because we know as we're at the top of the top as an RVP, when we get our SVP contract, what's gonna happen? Right? We're just gonna be at the top of the top of the top. Right? So I tell you guys, be the top at your position. Oh, and to stop looking at, oh my God, I wanna go, can I go, regional next month? Can I be an RVP in the next 22 days? No. Be the top of the top of your contract. Be the top of the top when it's your turn, right? And those are the people who always continue to move up to the next level, the top of the top in everything, okay? So hopefully you guys got something. I'm gonna go ahead here and I'm gonna pass it over to my business partner, my brother, Alejandro
Let's go.
Camejo.
Let's go.
How did you do? How did you do? How you
Let's go. This guy killed it. He got me fired up, man. While he was talking, guys, I was having flashbacks of when we were brand new in the business, going through all the no's, and I look back now, guys, it was so worth it, and about a year ago, we had just got our watch, fast forward to where we're at now, we're about to hit 200,000 in income this month, guys, and I pray to God every single day that, it'll happen for you guys too. We just showed up every single day. We put our heads up and we just kept working, guys. But today I'm gonna talk to you guys a little bit as to the mindset, mindset of Primerica. Yesterday I was talking to my coach, Edward, and I told him, hey, look, coach, what do you recommend me to read? What book do you think I should focus on?
And he told me this amazing book. It was so good, guys. I ended up listening to seven chapters of this book yesterday, right? So you guys are about to take in a bunch of information, guys. And remember, every book that you read, the average author is 42 years old, right? So whenever you're reading a book, you're taking in 42 years of experience, guys, you know. And last night, so I'm just gonna go over a few of the nuggets I got from this book yesterday. If you guys are writing, taking notes, the book is called What to Say When You Talk to Yourself, right? By Shahad Helmstetter, whatever his name is, right? So, have you guys ever imagined, guys, why some people become more successful than others? Why some people are more happy than others? Why, quote unquote, we say that some people get more lucky than others, guys? It's all in the having a better mental program. Right? It's all about having a mental better program, right? So the wall that stands in our way is our mind, right? Bullet point number one, take this note down, right? You become what you think about most. Whatever you put into your mind, you will get out, right? So a lot of the times we show up and we talk to ourselves. We say this in our head. We're like, man, I have no appointments. Stop telling yourself you have no appointments. Get on some appointments. Say, I will have some appointments today. Right? Stop telling yourself, man, I'm not gonna, I only wrote one policy this week. I have a slow week. I'm not gonna get anything done. Stop telling yourself those things, right? Because you're already preparing yourself for failure, right? It's super important to, you know, to talk to yourself in your brain and tell yourself, man, I will win. I will become a million-dollar earner. I am gonna become a regional leader this month, right? Like Bryce says every single day, right? I'm going regional, right? I'm going RVP, I'm going SVP. Those are things that are super important to tell yourself because at the end of the day, positivity is everything, right? You can't tell yourself negative things because that's what you're gonna attract. You're gonna attract negativity, not just that. Remember, your team is always listening to you, okay? Erase old negative program and replace it with positive, right? I saw a statistic yesterday. I was reading about this, right? And guys, for the first 18 years of our lives, right, we've been told no 148,000 times. I thought this was so powerful. 148,000 times from the moment you're born, Jonathan, to 18 years old, right? Somebody, one of your friends, one of your relatives, your mom, your dad told you no 148,000 times, right? But guess what? We've been told that we can do something maybe 100 times. Right. So in our early stages of life, right, we've already been programmed into our head, right, to know that, hey, look, no. So when you bring somebody into the business, what are they already thinking? So, doubt, right? They're like, no, I don't know if I can do this, right? I've been thinking, I spoke to my mom, she told me no, I can't do something like this, right? So you got to make sure, right, you're bringing that self-belief and you're telling yourself every single day that it can be done. Okay, because 75%, right? 75% or more of our program is the wrong kind, right? The other percentage is positive kind. So it's a positive, right? So imagine, Damien, right? If you got on a plane, right? Imagine if you got on a plane and you heard the pilots talking. They said, hey, there's a 75% chance that this plane is going to crash because 75% of the programming is bad, right? It's bad. Would you get on that plane? You probably wouldn't get on that plane, right? It's the same thing that's happening in our brains, right? 75% of our brains is determined to fail because our whole lives, from the moment we're born to 18 years old, we've been told no 148,000 times. So what does that mean, guys? You got to make sure to control everything by using the right programming with the right vocabulary. Okay, reading books, right? That's super important. Rewire and erase the old negative thoughts and use that and replace it with positive thoughts, right? Listen to audios, listen to books. Those are things that are super important. I believe it's changed the way I think. You know, one of the things when I first got started in the business, because, you know, one of the main reasons why I dropped out of school, guys, was the semester right before I had to take public speaking, right? I hated speaking in front of public. And I hated business. I hated numbers. I hated math. I was a bio major, you know. But it's crazy, you know. Whenever you run away from things, it's worse, right? You got to go towards it, right? That's how you overcome that fear, right? And whenever I came into the interview with Edward, right, I told him, hey, Edward, bro, I'm popular. I know a bunch of people. I'll do great at this business. But guess what? As long as I don't have to talk in front of people, let's do it. I know here, and he was like, bro, don't worry, you won't have to talk to people unless you get good at this business. And fast forward to where we're at now, I mean, I've spoken in front of thousands of people, and it's all about confidence, guys. You know, at the end of the day, how I think of it is, you know, the people that I'm talking to, they want to listen to me because we're doing something that's right. You know, we've triple digit recruited for the last 9 months, right? We've done over 60,000 in premium for the last 6, 7 months. Right, this month we just promoted an RVP and we're top in our base shop. Right, we're at 31 recruits, almost 12,000 in premium, and at 12,000 in cash. And the pay cycle started, I think, 6 or 7 days ago. Right, and guys, I don't tell you that, you know, to brag or impress you, but if we can do this, anyone can, and it all starts here. Right, you got to believe in it before it happens. Right, faith is all about believing in something before you can see it. Right, before it happens. Right, so you got to make sure you believe in it. Fear and trauma begins at an early age. That's why therapists take kids back to an experience when they were a little kid, right? Because our whole lives we've been told no, we've been told you can't do it, we've been told, and sometimes guys, that's our own family, that's our own, you know, parents telling us, hey, look, hey, I don't think you should do this, Jake. Maybe you should go back to school. Maybe you should go back to becoming a physical therapist, right? Or becoming a valet, driving cars, right? Because they don't think you can do that, right? So already that negative talk is you already programmed your mind that, hey, I can't do this because my parents have told me my whole life, my family has told me my whole life that I can't do this, right? Doubt kills dreams more than failure does. That's why people get started here in the business and within their first day, they haven't even started. They haven't even failed yet. And they're already telling you, hey, I've been thinking, I don't know if this is something for me because that doubt that attacked them, right? That doubt got into their head and they're already, you know, they're already failing, right? So what do you got to do, guys? You got to program your brain with the right vocabulary, right? The right environment is everything. That's why we tell people to show up to the office at 9:30 every single day, right? Because we know you show up, you're going to be surrounded by winners. You're going to be surrounded by people making a lot of money. And we have the right intentions for you guys. So we want to make sure that you guys win, right? Think about it. What other place out there is going to teach you personal finances, people skills, how to dress nice, right? How to talk to people, how to treat your parents the right way, right? How to treat your wife the right way, right? No other place will teach you those things, right? But Primerica does because we know it all starts here, right? It all starts what you're telling yourself, that positive mindset, right? And then of course, right? So just to erase the old negative program and replace it with positive, right? Same thing here. So let me ask you guys a question, right? I saw this yesterday too, and I thought it was so powerful, right? So Johnny, I'll use you as an example because you're right in front of me. Imagine there was two wolves, right? This is pretty good. Imagine there was two wolves. One was raised in the dark, one was raised in the light, right? Which one would you say would live the longest?
No reason why.
Yeah, which one do you think, Damien?
Light.
Huh?
Light.
The light, why?
Easier.
Yeah, see?
Sees everything? It's actually the one you feed, right? It's not the one, it doesn't matter where you were raised, it doesn't matter the culture, the surrounding that you're in, it's all about what you're feeding your brain, right? So it doesn't matter, right? Where you, I repeat that, right? It doesn't matter, guys, where you were raised, the surrounding, your parents, the negative friends that you surround yourself by. As long as you put into your brain the right thing, the right knowledge, as long as you're feeding yourself the right thing, you will be the one that succeeds here. I had a bunch of friends here, guys, you know, growing up in the business that told me, right, that told me that this business wasn't gonna work for me. But guess what? I didn't listen to them. It's like, remember, guys, that a battery, what does a battery need to work? A battery needs a positive and a negative, right? Without the negative and the positive, it doesn't work. Right, so we got to make sure, right? We got to make sure that we have those negative people. Use that as fuel. Use that as fuel to your tank and go out and win, right, guys? But that's a little bit after the book that I read yesterday. I think it was super powerful. I think you guys should definitely focus on reading something. Whatever you're lacking in life, guys, go pick up a book. If you don't like reading, listen to an audio, right? Because at the end of the day, remember what you put into your mind is everything. Not just that, it's what you're going to be able to deliver to your team, right? You gotta gain that wisdom, guys. But today, right, Lewis covered a little bit about field training, how we take people, you know, off to a fast start, what our journey looked like here in the business, how we always maintain the team. But I'm going to talk to you guys as to, you know, the top 10 points to having a successful orientation, which I don't call it an orientation. I call it a business plan. And you know, I thank my team because honestly, they think like I'm one of the best at doing a business plan. And every time I'm doing an orientation, they just sit next to me and they take a bunch of notes. So hopefully, I'm able to deliver to you guys and help you guys sound just as good as me, if not even better. You know, and to be honest, guys, that was probably the thing that I sucked at the most when I first got started. That's why I'm so good at it now, because the same exact thing you guys are doing with me now, I did with you are. We sat down. It got to the point that I had sharp recruits coming in, and I was like, "Man, I don't even want to do their orientation, bro. You can do it." I was a regional. A year into the business, I still had Edward helping me out with appointments, right? So I just got really, really good by sounding just as him, right? Having the same tonality as him, right? Making sure that I get very excited because people feed off your energy, right? And the more energy you give somebody, the more energy they're going to be able to give back, right? So number one, right? You got to make sure that you prep the training before you get on. Right? You got to make sure that you tell the person, hey, look, today we're going to schedule 3 to 4 appointments. Right? We're going to schedule 3 to 4 appointments. I'm going to show you how to make $1,000 within your first week. I'm going to show you how to build a team. We're going to make calls. And you got to prep the training before. If they don't know they're going to make calls, when you get to that list, you tell them, hey, today you're going to make calls, Johnny. They're going to be like, what? Because you didn't prep them throughout the presentation. You got to prep them early on, okay? Number two, right? In person is the best way for you guys to do a business plan, to do an orientation. It's a lot easier for somebody to come in here and schedule appointments when you do it in person. So whenever you hire a new agent, if they live 30 minutes, if they live an hour away, you guys have to make sure that they come here. I believe Ryan wouldn't be as successful as he is right now if he didn't show up to the office, right? And it took him about a month to come in. He's showing up to all our meetings, right? Even Bryce knows he's showing up to all our meetings, all our PDRs on Zoom with a hoodie, with dreads over his face. I told him, bro, you want to win? You keep texting me at 10 o'clock at night telling me that you want to be successful, that you want to win, that you want to accomplish your goals and dreams. You got to show up to the office because at home, you're not going to do anything. I told him just like that. You guys can ask him, right? Next day, he showed up in a full navy suit. That's the picture that he has that we use for recognition everywhere, right? And from that day on, he started changing, right? Everything changed for him. That's if it weren't for that, he wouldn't have met Edward, and Edward wouldn't have convinced him to drop to leave the military, right? So that's why it's so powerful, so important to make sure that you're plugging your people into the office, right? Because it's not about what you say, Bryce, but it's about what somebody else says it, but a little bit different, right? Sometimes your people won't listen to you, but they'll listen to somebody else, right? Because they hear you saying it all the damn time. They're like, man, this guy's just telling me this because he wants to make money off me, right? But if he hears it from somebody else that isn't making money from them, right now they're like, damn, these people actually care about me. These people actually want me to win, right? So it's super important to make sure that you're plugging your people into the office. If they're close by, right, you lose nothing and you gain everything, right? Sell out to the crusade. Right, that's number three, right? Whenever you're doing a business plan, the first thing that you want to do is you want to sell out, right? I show it, Lewis and I, we show we have a little gallery, right, of pictures of all the pictures, and I got this from Art Martinez, all the pictures of all the trips that we've been able to go to. And if you guys haven't gone on 20 trips, you can go on POL, you can look up all the trips that we've been able to go to. Colorado, Hawaii, I think there's a trip in DR, whatever. There's a Bahamas, right? I have a picture of all of those. Us walking the stage, us getting recognition, right? I'm selling the crusade, right? Because if I tell you something, Damien, you might not believe it, but if you see it, now it's true, right? So I'm selling the crusade by what else am I showing? I'm showing the cash, right? I'm showing the cash. So I go on production leaderboard. Everybody has access to this, right? I go on production leaderboard and I'm showing people what they can make as a brand new rep within their first 15 to 20 days. I'm showing people what they can make as a district leader, which is what I'm going to show you where to get to today. I'm going to show you how to become a district leader. Right? I'm showing people what they can make at regional, showing people that contract is not what pays you as a person because there's regional leaders in the company making 10, 15, $20,000 a month. There's RVPs making 2, 3,000, right? So I'm showing them that it's not the contract, it's the person that pays them. Right, I'm showing the company trips, all the rings. Right, I'm selling out to the crusade so that like that they get what they get belief that it can be done, right? And number four, right, figure out what the recruit wants for himself. Right, I try my best to know what exactly somebody's looking for. Right, and I ask simple questions. Right, I ask these questions. I say, what's your name, bro? Dominic, I'm gonna ask you, I ask you, right? I see you're brand new, so that's why I'm picking on you. I'll ask somebody in the queue, like Dominic. I'll ask you, hey, look, Dominic, I want to get to know you. I want to know what you want, right? If money wasn't an issue, what are some of the things that you want, that you would want in life, right? That's the first question, right? If money wasn't an issue, what are some of the things that you would want in life? What type of car would you like? Would you want to retire your family? Do you like traveling?
Sure.
Yeah, okay. Thank you. All right. What about you, Jonathan? Where would you want to travel?
Man, I want to go all over the world, like Italy, San Francisco. I mean, I want to go everywhere.
Yeah,
Yeah.
nice. And then I'll write it down, guys. I'll write it down. I'll actually look down and I'll write it down. What type of car would you want to drive?
Porsche 911.
Porsche 911. I'll write it down, right? And then and most people, guys, whenever they come into this business, they usually have another job, right? That's stopping them from accomplishing their goals and dreams. Sometimes it's not even a job. Sometimes it's a partner, somebody that's negative in their life. So I'll tell them, hey, Jonathan, based on where you work at right now, right? Do you think your boss will ever pay you enough money for you to accomplish those things that you want in life?
Probably not, no.
Probably not, right? So then you have two options then, right? Option number one is stay where you're at because you're comfortable there, right? It's what you know how to do. But the cons of you staying where you're at is you got to give up on all of these things happening for your life, right? Are you prepared to do that?
No, definitely
You
not, no.
definitely not, right? So your second option, right, is to take what I'm going to show you today. Right, because anything that you want in life, Primerica will deliver it. See, I just showed you all the company trips I've been able to go to. I've showed you what district leaders can make here. I showed you all the people in the office that are making a bunch of money. Right? Last month, Jonathan, this business paid me over $18,000. English is my second language. I was born in a third world country. I've only been doing this for I'm crossing off 4 years in the business next month. Right? If you're not talking to your people like that, that's why they're giving up. That's why they're quitting. That's why you're not retaining people, right? And I'll tell them, hey, Jonathan, I didn't know this was gonna happen, but guess what? I wanted it to happen, right? Because I live my life by design and not by what? By default, right? And last but not least, Jonathan, how fast do you want to do this? How fast do you want this to take place? All the things that you want to accomplish in life.
Man, out ASAP as soon as
At
possible.
ASAP, right? And I'll write that down, ASAP. Right? Guess what, guys? Now district leader matters. Right? If I didn't tell him all of those things, if I didn't figure out what he wanted, if I didn't tell him that, hey, look, where you're working at right now, that's not gonna get you there. If I didn't give him the two options to stay there or to give this everything he got, because anything that he wants here can happen for him. What is district leader? It doesn't matter, right? But now he understands that district leader matters, right? So if you're not asking your people that before the orientation, everything else after that, it's like it goes through here, exits through here. All they're thinking about is all the negativity that they're gonna get from their family whenever they talk to them, right? So you gotta make sure that you're prepping your people, right? Overcome the negativity before, right? This is really good, right? You gotta overcome all the negativity. So let's say I'm talking to Bryce, right? He's brand new. He's brand new in the business. I'm gonna tell him, hey, Bryce, be prepared, right? You're gonna go home. You're gonna be super excited. You're gonna start talking to your sister, your brother, your auntie, your uncle. They're gonna tell you, hey, look, this isn't for you. Why, Bryce? Because your family has never seen you as somebody that sells life insurance, somebody that wants to build a business, somebody that wants to make $100,000 a year. So be prepared for that, right? If they're not living the life that you want to live, Ari, then you probably shouldn't listen to them, right? So I'm prepping my people. I'm telling them that. I'm prepping all the negativity that they will get so that like that, whenever they go home and they hear that, they're like, oh yeah, my coach told me this was gonna happen. Right? I'm ready to hear it. Go. Hit me. What? I can't do this. I can't do it. All right, bet I'm gonna show you that I can. Right? So you gotta make sure that you're prepping your people before they come in. All of this is the business plan, guys. 3 by 3. At the end of the day, guys, you can do a whole business plan. The person leaves and tomorrow they'll call you and they'll be like, Jake, what was it that I needed to do to get promoted? They don't know. They don't remember, right? Because there's just so much information. All they remember, Nelson, is that you fired them up, that they believe in the business, you sold them to the Crusade, they can get licensed here, they can make money, and they're following a great leader, right? That's all that they can remember, that they're following somebody that they want to be like or alike or very similar to, right? So you guys have to make sure that you're overcoming all the negativity, right? People telling them that it's not going to work, not feeling comfortable talking to people, that self-belief, you got to overcome all of that. right, throughout the presentation. Ask the number six, right? Ask the new applicant the right questions, right? It's all about asking the right questions throughout the presentation, okay? So what are some of the questions that you can ask? And I'll go through the last few points here quick for you guys, right? So some of the questions, right? Nelson, would you rather be an employer? Would you rather be an employer? Employer, right? Those are recruiting questions. What am I doing here? I'm fixing his mindset to know that, hey, look, recruiting is normal if he wants to be what? An employer, if he wants to be a business owner, if he wants to make passive income, right? Do you want to do the business fast or do you want to be, or do you want to do the business slow? That is from Edward, right? Do you want to do the business fast or slow? The faster you do it, the easier it's going to be, the more money you make. Now he knows today we got to do the business fast. We're going to create a list. We're going to make phone calls fast, okay? How fast do we want to get promoted? Within the next 2 to 3 business days. Stop telling your people that they're going to get promoted in 30 days. That's not attractive. I don't want to be, I want to get promoted in 2 to 3 days. I want to make $600 in the next 3 days. Show me how to do it, right? I want to make $1,000 within my first week here in the business, right? Do you want to go see easy appointments, right? Easy appointments, people that love, care, and support you? Or do you want to go see people, or do you want to make cold calls, go door-to-door knocking, people that are probably not going to respect you, probably don't like you, probably not going to want to hear you? Which one do you want to go see?
That I know.
People that you know, people that love you, people that care about you, people that support you. Now they're going to understand why we want to go see their family. Right? So all I'm doing is I'm just like, it's all mindset, guys. I'm just like picturing like what, like exactly what I want them to do by asking them the right questions. Right? So do you want to be an employer? Do you want to do the business fast or slow? And of course, the last one, right? Do you want to go see easy appointments or do you want to go see people that are probably not going to support you? Easy. These are tie down questions. Like there's only one real answer to it, and it's the answer that you want.
That's right.
Right? That's why we ask it, right? Three reasons to get promoted, right? Three main reasons to get promoted. One, you want to be an example. This is a monkey see, monkey do business, right? The faster you get promoted, the faster you get, you build a bonus, the faster you get licensed, JJ, the faster your team will do it. Okay. You want to be an example. Number two is you want to get a bonus, right? You want to make money. You want to make money here within the next 2 to 3 days. So we got to get promoted. And the best part about it is I'm going to be doing the talking for you. I'll build you a team. I'll build you a client base. Remember, guys, one of the main things, a lot of the reasons why people fail in this business or why they quit is because they think that they're going to be the ones doing the presentation. Believe it or not, but like sometimes they do an orientation, they're like, oh, man, thank God you're going to do this for me, because if not, I don't think I could do this. I tell them, hey, look, I got your back. I'm really good at the business. You put me in front of 6 appointments. We don't get any results. I'll give you your 124 back, right? I promise you, you put me in front of 6 appointments, we will receive results. Right?
We will.
I think it's either there or somebody in the room.
Somebody in the room? Good? All right, cool. So I just lost my train of thought. But we want to get on 6 appointments up, right? So you put me in front of 6 people, we're going to see results. We're going to get promoted. We're going to build you a bonus, right? So people like getting trained by somebody that has confidence, right? If you have no confidence, then at the end of the day, you know, they're just not going to want to work with you. And what is the result, guys? If you land on 6 appointments and you can't close one, I'm sorry, but you need to go talk to your upline, right? I know that in worst case scenario, what is result? Result is you, Karina, you're going to learn. That's a result. So if you get on 6 appointments and your trainer tells you, hey, look, we didn't get any results. Well, did you get better? Did you learn? Did you learn how to run quotes? Did you learn the presentation? Did you learn how to build rapport? Did you learn how to maybe ask the closing questions? Okay, then we got results. You got better, right? A result is not always closing, right? A result can be you learning. That's what we're here for, right? For you to learn. But at the end of the day, you got to tell them, hey, you put me on in front of 6 appointments, you're going to see results. And of course, that 50% bonus. What's the pros of you doing it through me? Well, I'm very good at this business. You put me in front of people, I will get you results, okay? And the other one, right? 3 reasons to go see family. Well, they're easy appointments. You're going to get results and business, right? You want to make sure you write down these bullet points because you want to make sure you tap into these little examples, right? Schedule 4 to 5 KTs, right? Within the first The first day that they come in, you're doing the orientation. You want to make sure that you schedule 4 to 5 appointments with their family, right? Family, friends, coworkers, anyone that is either married or single with kids, because there's a 95% chance that if you go sit down with somebody who's married or single with kids, they'll know somebody else that is married or single with kids. Okay, 4 to 5 KTs within the first day. That's how I can tell you did a successful orientation. Right, if you come to me, I'm gonna ask you, hey, how many appointments did you schedule? If you didn't schedule at least 4, then guess what? You didn't do a great job. Okay, that person doesn't believe when you're joined, right? And it's not always just making a phone call. You can make the phone call for them. Right? If somebody is scared to make the phone call to their family, you do it. You do it for them, right? Especially if they're right next to you. Right? Make the phone call for them, right? Get 10 warm market referrals. Guys, social media is amazing. I'll finish with this. Social media is amazing, but you don't want to stay in social media, right? You want to get out of that. How we built this business is warm market. Okay. For example, how I found Ryan, I found this guy named Rick Castillo on social media. I was sending out messages, right? Because that's how I gain activity. Sending out messages. He came in, I did his orientation. On the orientation, he had Bryce, right? Bryce came in, I did his orientation. On the orientation, he put Emily. So how did I find the 150 by 70,000 team that I have now? Warm market referrals, 10 names and numbers, right? Emily came on board, 10 names and numbers, found Ryan, right? And here we are now, first regional vice president. We're running a hierarchy now, and I know we're just going to keep promoting people out of this amazing hierarchy, right? But that's pretty much my training for today. I'm 1 minute over. Hopefully you guys learned something today. Hopefully we delivered for you guys. I believe we have like 14, 15 days left till the month is over. So let's go ahead and deliver, guys. Remember, it's not how you start the year, but it's how you end it, right? 2024 starts today. Go out and finish the year strong. Go out and accomplish your goals and dreams. So like that, 30 days from now, you can be ahead of everybody else that's starting in January, right? Love you guys. See you at the top. Who are we? Who are we?
Let's go.
That
was
crazy.
Want to talk about when you're by yourself?
Yeah, what to say when you're by yourself? What to say when you're what to say to yourself? Yeah. So one easy appointment.
Oh.
Easy appointment. Number two, referrals. Referrals, and then three business. Thank you. And then three business. But what do you say?
It's all the way through.
That's good.
Wait, oh, there you go. Bro, we got it. It's like, I think I'm done. It's all
good. Do you learn something more? Just don't do it for a long time.
Like 30 seconds. Hey, look, this is, whatever you have.
Thank you, bro. Hopefully you have
that made statements wasn't more than
Yeah, it's all your team.
It was the best.
Un día lleno de bendiciones. Deseo un día lleno de bendiciones a todos, en todos sus planes, citas y aplicaciones las puedan completar en el día de hoy y sean todos para bien. Como siempre, tenemos que decir que estoy aquí para todos ustedes. Deseo un día lleno de bendiciones, que todo les salga bien nuevamente. Las aplicaciones, ya que los planes estarán pagando a ustedes adicional por eso. Recuerden, no es contestar las preguntas como dice, simplemente la manera de tú hablar con el paciente en base a sus medicamentos que la persona toma, tú puedes determinar